Don't worry about a thing. Just pull the trigger, son. It's gonna be a little, you know, like, you don't know whether you should or you shouldn't, but you know that the pressure's on and you better do it, okay? And you pick up the gun and then you point it, all right? Okay?
There it comes. 3 feet. Right down.
This is so ridiculous. This is scary.
Nice action, you start the dialogue. Don't matter.
Fuck it, Holmes. La primera
2 weeks after I got off the set, I got shot. I was blind instantly. I got shot in the face, in the neck, the arm, my chest, my head. It's kind of ridiculous being a victim of a drive-by shooting when I just done a act for a drive-by, you know? I didn't even get to see the movie. If God's here with me and he wants me to see again, then I know I'll be able to see again. You know, I just have faith in myself. But if I don't get to see again, then oh well, you know? Life goes on.
Joy is one of the gang members who acted in American Me, a movie I directed about Mexican-American gangs. What happened to Joy is typical of gang life in East Los Angeles. I grew up in this neighborhood. Gangs were active when I was a kid, but today the violence is much worse. Last year, there were over 800 gang-related murders in Los Angeles County alone. This is a documentary about what we learned from the gang members who helped us make American Me on the streets of East LA and in the prisons of California.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro.
No, mami, nos tenemos que ir, que tenemos una fiesta que hacer, sí, mami. No, yo no tengo que ir con los... por agua así tan rico. No esperen más, nada más brinquen en el piso. Yo lo voy a patear como un costumbre, chica, y sé cómo lo quieres y cómo lo necesitas. Duro y suave, rápido, con salsa.
The name of the gang right here in the project is Big Hazard. We expand to the other side of White Side, to the roller coasters, towards Lincoln Park. And that's our area. This is all Hazard Grande, and it's been here for since the project's ever been built.
The name of our gang is MC Force. Like you can see right there, it's MC Forceros. This is the heart of our neighborhood, Michigan Avenue, MC Force. As you can see right here, we had a mural, but the cops came across the side.
We are what you could say a big family, Big Hazard, you know? And if anything happens to one of our homeboys, we react by going into it. What happened? Who did it? And we will look for revenge.
Another neighborhood comes down to our neighborhood and crosses out. That's where the trouble starts, you know? We say, we get mad and we just say, fuck them, you know, let's go to their neighborhood, we see one of them, let's kill them, you know. We don't care.
Not everyone would choose to make a movie in the midst of these gangs, but I wanted the story to be realistic. We began shooting in the Boyle Heights section of East LA.
Blow that window.
And now we've all made movies. The only difference between this movie and other movies is that we're stuck in between a war zone. We're right in the cusp of like three different groups of kids. And what Anna's afraid of, and rightfully so, is that there are so many Hazard kids here. And she's afraid that it's going to cause a confrontation.
They don't start giving them the power because then they believe in taking over.
My biggest concern was safety. By bringing in hundreds of people that are normally not here, it'd be very easy for someone to drive by and fire a shot.
Checking it out, and you could be going through your stacks of 45s, making sure you have the right ones, you know, for later in the party. Right? Okay? Just to give you some business
so
to
this
do.
This is all I do right now.
This is all you're going to do right now, just so we establish...
There was no way we could film in these neighborhoods without the cooperation of rival gangs. After weeks of negotiation, they agreed to a truce. And many became actors in the movie.
Acting like it don't hurt, you know what I mean? But it hurts. And you're watching it. And you're sitting there going, yes, I was. Okay?
And action!
La Primera lives, that's it. It lives through us. It gives to us. It is us.
It's more than that's all we got.
It's all we've ever had.
When I first heard that other gangs were gonna be up here, I was feeling like, oh, are we gonna fight in the thing or we're gonna film? But they're sitting with us and eating with us. We know that they're there and they know that we're here. We're taking it as professionally right now, and we're sitting at the same table. They're just right there.
They're here together. They're working from 5 o'clock in the evening to 5 o'clock in the morning. It's real stressful. It's real heavy. They become sleepy, irritated, and. But yet, it has continued on. This is her second day.
Everybody came but one.
Ana Lizaraga. She's a former gang member who now works to keep kids out of gangs. She's lost several family members to gang violence.
How many have you got from Hazard?
Her job was keeping peace on the set.
We have hired the kid that might just have been out of jail for 3 days and needed a job. We hired the kid that was pulling out of a game, but didn't have the tools to pull out of the game. So they have a different experience. They're real excited making this movie because each one of them had a role in a part in it.
It's great. It's great.
It's been tiring, actually.
Yeah. Yeah. Tiring.
I have a headache right now.
Say
that.
Being here till 5 o'clock in the morning.
This is my first time on a scene, and I didn't know it takes so long just to film a little piece of scene. And it's just real weird, because this is all my life. This is reality to me. And right here, they put it on film. It's like they're getting little parts here and there. But in my neighborhood, this is all reality, all these cars and all these. The way we're dressing, this is my original dress. That's how I really dress like this.
All right. Neto up there.
Snoop. Some of the kids also help decorate the sets.
Let's see if you can get a nice stack of writing coming down. H-A-Z.
Old writing?
G-R-D, yeah.
Like real old writing?
Yeah, it's a little bit what Payaso is doing, yeah. Payaso, he made me a deal. If I put his name somewhere prominent, he'd paint for me.
They're the art department, that's me.
Before you go out your door, you pray, God, I hope I don't get shot today. I mean, it's already in your conscience before you walk out your door.
If you're in a gang, you're not living life. Because wherever you go, you gotta be looking over your shoulder. Even in your own neighborhood, in your own territory, you gotta just make sure, just to be sure, nobody's there.
Well, I was coming home from the movie set. They already called it cut, and they started shooting at me. I got shot in the shoulder, my bones. It's all, right now it's all sore and everything, but it's starting to heal better now. But it's just something that, you know, it's L.A., you know, just living in East L.A. Things happen.
Action!
The gang members we worked with have a lot in common with the characters in American Me. The film follows the life of Santana. Santana's gang was his family.
Get the spark plug.
One night, Santana and his gang decide to test their machismo.
Don't move!
No, no, go, man, go!
They get busted.
Turn your head to the left.
short sentence in juvenile hall turns into 18 years in prison. Santana becomes the leader of one of the most ruthless and powerful gangs in prison history. Any one of these kids could turn out to be a Santana. Like him, they want to make a mark on the world. They're in search of identity, a sense of belonging.
To write it down on walls is an important thing for us gangs, so we could get known to other gangs. It's like advertising our own gang. When I see other gangs graffiti in my neighborhood, we feel mad because they ain't supposed to come in and disrespect our neighborhood. If we see them, we're gonna do something. We got something to shoot them with, they're gonna get shot at. We're really fighting about neighborhoods disrespecting other neighborhoods. They come over here, start shooting at us, but there's sometimes that they're too scared that they don't want to get off the cars or nothing. They just shoot the stupid way and hit innocent people. This is the spot where they killed one of my homeboys, Tico. His name was Javier Gonzalez. He was shot 3 times by a 45 caliber gun. He passed away on April 8, 1990. It makes me angry because he was the one that started our neighborhood, MC4s. And you know, they just came down. They had to call him out from his house. The car was waiting. And as soon as he got to the spot, they just came and they shot him. He was just like a brother to me, you know, because I never had brothers. And he used to care for me a lot. We used to care for each other. He never let me down in any other way, not even to all the homeboys. He wasn't scared of nothing. No matter who it was or what it was, he was always down for the neighborhood.
Grow up, you know, like brothers and sisters, and a unity. People don't understand that, but Hazard is one big family, that's all.
Come here, give me your hand. You know what I see? We got our own clique, strong clique.
The scene of Mundo being inducted into the gang is really the acceptance, the rite of passage.
Our clique, our barrio, our families, that's all we got is.
The tattooing of the hand is a symbol of this whole feeling of camaraderie. They usually feel that they're outside of society, and they need to feel like they're part of something, so they get involved with gangs.
Welcome to the clique, carnal. Por vida, por vida.
I was in, I got out, and I went back in. You know, when I got out, it was just, I said to myself, damn, why did I even get out? Because I was out and I was still claiming my neighborhood. I was still looking for trouble. Everybody that came, where you from? I said, it's that MC4's gang.
There ain't no way out of Hazard. You get married, 25 kids, 5-6 houses, you're still gonna be from Hazard, you know what I mean?
I remember when we were just a couple of mocosos, causing trouble all the time and getting caught with rubabosos. But it was fun and we had so many good times. Me and you, we put our troubles behind. It was the two of us, sticking it day and night. Looking forward to the chance that we were getting a fight. Toe-to-toe street boxing, putazos cada día. Then we met up with some vatos that belong to a pandilla. They hit us up, where you from? I said, nowhere, man. They replied real quick, and said, get jumped into our gang. Nosotros controlamos aquí, chavalas. We heard that you were tough, but sabes que we call the balas. I looked at my carnal, my homie, my dog. Before I had a chance, the guys just hit him with the log. Ran up to homeboy, and I gave him a putazo. Busted him in the grip, but todavía no hizo caso. They jumped me from behind. I tried to hold my ground. Before I knew it, man, my bitch, your body went down in the days. De verdad no me recuerdo. All I could remember was my homie sufriendo. It only lasted about a minute or two, but to me, it seemed like it would never be through. After they rushed us, they came and shook our vices. Now they respect us, before they despised us. We're in a gang now, pues y moro. Me and my homie became two down cholos. I remember you, homie. I remember you, homie. Yes, I remembered you like if it was yesterday.
I'm always gonna love this neighborhood. And I'm always gonna be proud to say I represent Hazard. And I knew that by me loving my neighborhood so much, I was gonna end up dying for it.
It's a good thing that I'm still alive right now, bro. You know, I seen people get killed right here in front of me. I seen it happen, you know, with my eyes.